This is a multiplayer session between Herman Hum and Alexandre Helart. Alexandre is living in the People's Republic of China, and he wanted to play a scenario in his neck of the woods. So we selected the 10.0 scenario named Shadow. Interception, interpretation of rules of engagement. Here is the scenario background in the Sea of Dragons battle set. The duration is 24 hours. Our orders are: to enforce a blockade around the separatist province of Formosa. By enforcing the blockade, we will stop, search, and seize any ship. In Harpoon ANW, it is not possible at this time to conduct seizures. In the Harpoon Ultimate version 3.10 of this game, it is possible to seize, capture a ship. Unfortunately, it's not possible to play multiplayer, as any attempt to start a multiplayer session in version 3.10 causes a crash. So we are stuck with stopping, searching, and destroying. Our victory conditions are to sink 3 merchants, since we cannot board and seize 2. We have an enforcement flotilla consisting of 3 destroyers and a number of frigates acting as search and picket elements. I wrote this scenario many years ago, and it's good that I've forgotten where and what my enemy actually has. So we approach the scenario as though it's the very first time. I don't know where he's coming from, but it's generally from this, looking from where the picket line set, it's probably from this direction. I have my picket elements, and we're going to sit. We don't know the situation yet, so we'll be sailing back and forth in skirmish line to try and pick up the enemy units. No air assets are available. Immediately, surface contacts are detected. These are known as skunks. We are checking the various emissions detected from the radar. It looks like common navigational radar from the merchant mariners, civilian transports, commercial vessels. Nothing untoward or suspicious at this time. So we'll keep operating and trying to localize some of these. Just in case these are enemy, our nearest frigates will move to classify and identify them. One super tanker has been classified, but we still don't know which side it's on, so we must get visual confirmation. We can tell by their size and radar return, but we don't know which flag under which they fly. So we are forced to close the range and know for absolute certainty. The container ship is classified definitely as a neutral. We can go back to our patrol station as previous. Another cargo ship is classified as neutral, and we can leave her alone. Merchant fishing dhow, but it's unlikely this is, and a more supply vessels, just local fishermen. Another container ship, innocent passage. These are very busy waterways. More container vessels are heavy lift vessel, and a container vessel is detected. Even at a range of only 5 or so miles in the daylight, we're still having a problem identifying them. Luckily, we have a major speed advantage over them, so we can catch them. I'm maintaining a passive sensor watch by not activating any sonar, jamming, or radar systems. I'm trying to keep myself hidden from any potential enemies within the straits. I could turn on the radar and immediately have a much better picture of the area, but I don't want to reveal my position. I'm seeing that many of the boat skunk contacts, the unknown contacts, are moving at 20 knots. Fairly fast speed, but not unreasonably fast. I've increased speed for all my picket units to 20 knots as well. If the civilian vessels are moving at this speed, I can hide myself by moving at the same speed. Moving at a speed of 31 knots or so, 30 plus knots, is very unmistakable as a naval vessel, as there are few commercial vessels that are able to make this speed. Plus, the fuel consumption is much higher at this speed. So this reveals itself to be a naval vessel because of its high rate of transit. So once we catch it and classify, I will slow down. All contacts are confirmed as neutrals, merchants moving through the area. I still have no idea where the enemy is. I may have to go active with my radar coverage in case he's trying to sneak in between, but I doubt very much that he could get lucky enough to get past me. So I'll maintain the passive radar watch. A supertanker and liquefied natural gas tanker have been detected. They're moving quite suspiciously at the same speed, so I am going to investigate more closely. In addition, a number of container ships are also moving at 18 knots, and another supertanker. So I think this might very well be the enemy task group or convoy which I've been seeking. Looks like he's tried to go around the south, which is fine. We move our other ships, the enforcement flotilla, as well as the other picket ships, to close on this suspected convoy. We twigged upon this possibility because they're all going 18 knots. So it looks like a group of ships moving in unison. My frigate has just been destroyed for no return. At this time, the enemy is likely aware of my position or of my stance. We increase speed to flank and close on the targets. A vampire. Looks like it was detected just before it struck the frigate. So those missiles are lost to me. I don't think we're saving anything, so we're going active with our radar. At least as a picket option. This hopefully will give me any warning, at least a modicum of early warning of any inbound missiles. We're not hiding anything. I've activated the range ring for radar as well as our air defenses. As can be seen, the ships have nothing much in the way of air defenses beyond anti-aircraft artillery guns. So they're quite weak all around. Submarine and air defenses, but they do have a number of surface-to-surface missiles. The Luda-class destroyers can withstand more damage, but they're not very capable destroyers. A mass of ships are detected racing for the shore of the rebel province. We identify them by their speed, 18 knots as they were moving before. They're moving on parallel courses. Another ship moving at 25 knots has been seen exhibiting the fire control radar of a rebel destroyer. We'll classify it hostile and rename it. So we can classify all these ships. I am going to be presumptuous and classify them as hostile. We're going to engage the destroyer and try to strip away some of her protection. We'll order a quad pair of Sawhorse missiles from the next nearest missile-guided frigate. Another ship appears on radar. At 18 knots and parallel course, we'll classify her as part of an enemy convoy. Looks like the missiles have been seduced by another target. Something larger appeared on radar, and now they're chasing after it. What a waste. We don't know if anything's hit because these missiles are fire and forget. Looks like the only way we're going to get a certain kill here is by going in with guns. The enforcement flotilla. I'm detaching all units to maneuver independently. I'm re-engaging the missile, the destroyer, with four CSSN-8 Sakade. Let's see if this barrage will get through. Vampires are detected inbound. He's firing back. I wish I had... Looks like he's got surface-to-air missiles in the volley. We'll see if our missiles lock onto the correct target. Three of them are supposedly heading towards the destroyer. The destroyer will take approximately 87 hits damage points, and the CSSN-8s deliver 33 each. So it's hopeful that these should get through. Nope, another one shot down. Looks like we picked up a super tanker. And another container ship. The enemy has slowed and turned on his jamming systems. We will re-engage. I'll turn on the show data links, and we can see that our ships are sharing data with one another. Unfortunately, the missiles do not share data. We have no linkage back to the launching platforms. He's launched missiles back towards me. Looks like it's time to use them or lose them. The first Luda will re-engage with her seersuckers. As we can see with these Sakade and the seersuckers, there are no data links to the launching platform, so we cannot control. Oh, this one, they do have data links back to the ship, so these are slightly more modern and can take the radar feed from the Luda if she survives the enemy missile barrage. in hindsight, I should probably should have fired these first, but you cannot tell what capabilities the seersuckers have. It was the game database does not show these capabilities, and you would have to open them up with the database editor in order to find whether or not the missile had data links back to the ship. But she's fighting for her life now. Several inbound missiles. Looks like harpoons and 436. Don't know what kind of missiles these are. We don't have any emissions detected from them, but we've taken hits. And we're at 30% damage. The enemy also fights back with surface-to-air missiles. The Frams, I believe, are armed with a self-defense. Oh, there's Xiangfeng. Dragon's Wind, I think, and Sea Chaparral for defense. Jinan is crippled, barely creeping along. But she survives. The old Fram destroyers are World War II vintage, but they still carry a number of very effective guns, so it's important for us to try and destroy them. Here is a naval vessel. Looks like another Fram destroyer. We'll classify her hostile with the D hotkey, and the first destroyer is sunk. The second destroyer is engaged with another barrage of seersuckers. Now that we know these missiles have data links, we'll fire them towards the most potent enemy destroyers. The missiles that, since the first Fram is already destroyed, the follow-on missiles have selected alternative targets. Notice they're all moving at 7 knots, so this is probably another hostile. Cargo ship. Some hits and some total miss. The second Fram destroyer opens fire with her Xiangfeng missiles, but our birds are already off. The missiles cross paths in midair, but mine will arrive first since they have higher speed. They've autonomously activated radar. The enemy brings down two of them. Three, but they're too close now. He will not survive. And he's blown off out of the water. Luda fights for her life. She has guns and not much else. Some chaff rockets, perhaps. None. No chaff. She takes hits, and she's in very bad shape. One last missile barrage to survive. She's in the same state as the other Luda. Unfortunately, the enemy has one more missile than she can shoot down, and she's sunk. We continue to sail towards the enemy fleet, because even at 4 knots we might be able to catch a straggler. We'll check the damage report and see that our rudder and mount has been hit, but we are not in flooding or on fire, so that's a small Another enemy ship is detected moving at 27 knots. We know she's hostile from her previous emissions. She was jamming. Chien, this is the Aegis class destroyer, or not Aegis, but one of the standard missile destroyers given to them by the faithless Americans. It is another Fram class destroyer. The Jianghu is racing to get into missile speed, missile range. The Fram still has surface-to-air missiles, not many, but a few. And more Xiangfeng quad can launchers. She may have already launched hers in towards the Luda. But we don't need to kill destroyers. We need to kill merchants. So even as we chase, we are hoping to get within gun range. He can only defend from one flank. If there are no other destroyers, as long as we stay away from him, we can still destroy his cargo ships. The chase is on. Surprisingly, the enemy has turned around. What is his game? He's moving one direction and all of a sudden switching to the other. And we've activated the radar on the Luhu. One skunk is firing. More vampires inbound. We can now classify Skunk 87 as a missile armed destroyer. Some kind of military ship. So we will name it Navy. We don't know what it has given, no emissions, so we don't know if it's a frigate, destroyer, or other. But that's okay. This container ship is actually going faster than the others, so we would be difficult to classify them at here. Oh, here's another one. Moving at 27 knots, that's another hostile ship with no emissions to reveal its true nature. But we will call it Navy. The Luhu has a number of surface-to-air missiles fired in defense. She brings down the enemy surface-to-surface missiles. She mounts an octuple surface-to-air missile system with the reloading out of 8, but we're going to pull off. I'm going to withdraw and maintain the range until my surface-to-air missile system can be fully reloaded. It takes, we'll check the magazine and see that the Crotile reloads take approximately 10 minutes each. So I'd rather go in later than earlier. He's forced me off. Looks like he's turning to fight in hopes of getting his merchants free on a final sprint to the base. The Fram destroyer only carries a 76 millimeter gun, which has a range of approximately 4 miles. Luhu guns have a range of 7 miles, so we outrange them. But these other two Navy ships are unknown, so we don't know if we carry heavier armament than them. If they outrange us, they can pound us to dust as we close. So I am exercising restraint, and hopefully we can catch up with once we've fully reloaded. My opponent is a very worthy one. He's leaving his navy behind at slow speed while his valuable cargo ships race for safety. We know the range of effective range of this Fram, so we are going to close with the Jianghu. Jianghu has a gun system with 7.1 mile range, so we can easily pound this one to pieces. But we don't know about his other two navy because they're not turning on their radar systems. Good for him. So he's forcing me to, my Luhu is going to try an end run before pursuing the ships. If we can blast him, we'll try to approach from two angles. We also have follow-on frigates, but they're so far away they may not catch them at all before they actually reach their destination. So he's done well to minimize the effectiveness of my ships. We're going to try for a missile shot, and we can see that the Jiangdong doesn't even have weapons that can reach its very short-range gun frigate. The other Jianghu is too far away. Her missiles are out of range. This Jianghu will try to engage with more Sawhorse. We'll try to blast our way through the center of the enemy defenses. The missiles go astray and are tracked everywhere, but we've also forced the enemy to activate his radar and reveal himself. This is another Qian Yang destroyer. Same short-ranged guns. So we can sweep past her. We will rename her . This destroyer is also a Fu Yang, another Fram destroyer, but she has big guns. This is a 7 nautical mile range. So she is the same range as our Jianghu, and pretty much the same range, and Luhu. We're going to try to steer around her if at all possible. I've renamed her just to keep track of which destroyers are dangerous and which are not. We may have gotten a hit off this one, so she could be slower, and at least we can avoid her. She cannot force battle upon us, but as long as she is alive, 7 mile radius all around remains dangerous. My opponent is playing very well to keep maintaining the distance. The enemy Fram destroyer has come within range. We unload with our 100 millimeter gun. Several salvos splash. They have very short range guns, so we don't have to worry about them getting too close. His guns are approximately half the range, a little bit more than half the range of mine, two-thirds possibly. So we can pound him with virtual impunity. Our gun goes into battery and for reload. It doesn't look like we've slowed down the Fram destroyer, but this other one is only making 17 knots. Looks like we've damaged him badly. In the south, we're making our end run around the Fram destroyer with the larger guns. The enemy does not seem to be moving to try and cut us off. After reload, we re-engage. But we cannot, because the enemy destroyer, even though he's moving slowly, he has managed to intercede and place himself within range of our Jianghu. So we must run. Even at 17 knots, he has very well placed himself as a barrier. If we try to close on the Fram, the damaged Fram, we will run into range of his guns. We might win, but his destroyer can take 90 points of damage. Is probably half of that has already been sustained, and ours can only take 62. We don't know. A few lucky hits and we'd be sinking. But the enemy does not seem to be taking much notice of the Luhu coming from the south. The Jianghu has been leading the Fram on a nice merry chase. She seems to have slowed down. Maybe she's on fire and burning. That's okay. Now we can try to close on the rest of the convoy. Another Qian Fram with short-range guns remained behind, but now she's within range of our 100mm guns. We open fire from the Luhu. Take her out, and then we can sail in and ravage the flock. The chasing destroyer, Jianghu, is now within range of the Fram destroyer carrying the bigger guns. She'll unleash her sawhorse missiles in hopes of killing this destroyer and freeing up the way for the Jianghu to approach from the north. The Fram in the south has taken hits, lots of splashes and explosions, and seems to have slowed down to 21 knots out of a possible 27. We may have gotten some damage. The missiles are still inbound on the Fram, I guess we could call it with the Fuyang, probably a better name, to distinguish it from the other Fram destroyers. We'll reactivate the data links, but there are no data links from these sawhorse missiles. So there, we take our chances whether they're actually going to hit the destroyer or be seduced into chasing one of these other destroyers and or merchant vessels. The Qian seems to be a kill, but we don't want to be closing too quickly on it because the enemy could have slowed down just to playing possum. By slowing down to zero, we can't tell until we get visual confirmation, and by that time he might have visual on our own. Looks like our missiles are chasing our own ships. The Luhu appears to be tracked by a sawhorse. While another one chases a super tanker. This ship appears to be dead in the water. We don't even know what it is. There's no emissions, but it seems to be a burning hulk, and the sawhorse has locked onto her. Luckily, they run out of fuel. Even damaged, the Fuyang continues to drive off the Jianghu because with a range difference of only maybe 0.1 nautical miles, we are uncertain of actually winning this gun battle. So we're leaving. The Qian destroyer appears to have gone beneath the waves. The Fuyang runs back to provide gunnery support. A container boat falls victim and is seen sinking and on fire. We engage the next largest ship, and it's a liquefied natural gas tanker, trying to slow her down. We still are unable to ascertain the posture or the side to which this container ship belongs. We can't accidentally sink a neutral out here. Amazingly, the enemy appears to have turned back some of the ships directly towards me. The Qian class destroyer has only four nautical mile range guns, so we have some time. We can slow down to prevent closing range. That way, don't give the enemy an advantage. We can still hit him while he cannot hit us. The LNG tanker is burning and heavily damaged, only making 2 knots. The nearest super tanker is under fire from the lighter guns of the Luhu. Will we have sufficient ammunition to actually destroy her? I've already destroyed one container vessel. I need 3 to accomplish my victory conditions. The LNG tanker is reported sinking. One more to go. This one is damaged and on fire, only making 14 knots. But his Fu Yang is racing back to hopefully drive me off. And he will. If he comes after me, I'm not going to risk my Luhu. But I'm in so close to his super tanker that I can probably finish the job as I sail out. In the north, the Qian has decided to turn and try to fight the pursuing Jiang Hu. But we aren't, even though it shows within the range circle, it might be a little bit off. So we're still, there we go. Finally, at maximum range, we engage with our 100mm cannon. Super Tanker is still limping along at 9 knots as we pour round after round into her. The Qian is less dangerous with only 4-mile range than the Fu Yang, so we still want to stay away from Fu Yang. We don't want to take unnecessary casualties. My canny and cunning opponent has just increased speed. Looks like he may have been playing a game of possum with the Fu Yang destroyer. From slow poking along at 5 knots, he's increased speed to 17. The Skunk 42 is firing, and he's managed to bring my Jiang Hu under attack, under gunfire, inflicting 16-24%. He's hammering it hard. Now he's gone to dead in the water. Is he really dead? We check on his emissions and see that they're off, but is he really dead or only trying to draw me in closer? I thought I had sufficient separation, but it looks like I was wrong. Damage at 24% level still leaves me able to maneuver at flank speed. The Luhu increases speed to maintain separation from the Fu Yang as she pounds the supertanker to dust. She's sinking. So now we have 3 sunk ships. I think it's time to retire. We will leave the rebels with their 3 surviving ships as we return to port. My opponent says that he cannot achieve his victory conditions, and I've achieved my 3. So we're going to cut the game short, and I will resign at this point. A good game on the side of my opponent. However, see, I have accidentally sunk a neutral with one of my errant missiles. So technically, I cannot win this one. So even though the game has awarded me victory, I must concede this to my opponent and say that this is just a draw because I have drawn in a neutral nation to our conflict. Not my fault. I aimed at the right tank, at the right ships, but the missiles activated and took on a life of their own. In Harpoon 3, this would not happen. In A&W and HUE versions, yes, this does happen. We sank the 3 required. And we sank a merchant dhow accidentally. We lost 3 ships, 2 frigates and 1 destroyer. The enemy almost managed to put me off. He just didn't have enough left over at the right time. This concludes Shadow, written for the Player's Database.